Welcome to this course on Introduction to Lean. Lean is the set of management practices based on the Toyota production system. The phrase Lean Production was coined by a group of MIT researchers who wrote the book, The Machine That Changed the World. Lean system gives people the skills and a shared way of thinking to drive out waste. The single goal of the organization is to produce and deliver the best product at the lowest cost and as fast as possible. In Lean, this is achieved by empowered teams with long-term commitment, continuously looking for reducing variation, eliminating wastes, and keep things moving. The Toyota production system has five guiding principles, which when implemented, will result in a transformed organization. Principle number one. Value must be defined by the customer. Specifying this value is therefore the first step in a lean transformation. Principle number two. Identify all the steps in the value stream and eliminating the steps that do not create value. Principle number three. Make the value-creating steps occur in tight sequence, so the product will flow smoothly toward the customer. This requires the organization to move from a batch manufacturing philosophy to one of continuous flow, aiming at single-piece processing. Principle number four. Using the pull philosophy, each operation only pulls product from its prior operation when real demand exists at the downstream operation. Principle number five. The above four steps are repeated until a state of perfection is reached, in which perfect value is created with no waste. This slide summarizes the five principles of lean transformation discussed in the previous slide. Value can only be defined by the ultimate customer. Lean is all about delivering the value demanded by the customers, no more, no less. Once the customer value has been specified, various processes which are needed to deliver it are mapped. Value stream mapping is a lean manufacturing technique used to analyze and design the flow of materials and information required to bring a product or service to the customer. In a value stream map, you will find three types of processes: value-added work, incidental work, and non-value-added work. The intent of value stream mapping is to identify the non-value-added work and eliminate them. The next slide defines these three types of works. An activity is considered to be value-added if and only if these three conditions are met. 1. The customer must be willing to pay for the activity. 2. The activity must transform the product, making it closer to the end product. And the last condition, the activity must be done right the first time. Incidental works do not add value, but seem to be unavoidable. However, non-value-added works such as waiting, transport, over-processing, inventory, motion, and defects must be eliminated from the value stream. This principle requires the organization to move from a batch manufacturing philosophy to one of continuous flow, aiming at single-piece processing. This will in turn require eliminating setup times and ensuring reliable and predictable processes. Deliver only what is wanted by your customer, and only when they want it. This will lead to lower inventories of finished goods and work in progress. This principle requires the organization to move from production based on demand forecast to production based on actual customer demand. This will result in many positive changes in the organization, ranging from reduced cycle time, reductions in inventory, improved internal cooperation, and improve customer service levels. Principle number 5 is to create a culture of continuous improvement. The organization should continuously strive to become better every day. This is achieved by systematically and continuously removing the root causes of poor quality, with the ultimate goal of achieving zero defects.